Council's Millionaires Row. Not because of Wickham Street's nightclubs or restaurants, but because this strip has made the most money from parking fines.
Yeah, it saves a lot, especially when you're a pensioner. That's why I take the train now.
The most common offence, not paying the meter, then parking in a no-stopping zone, on a yellow line, in a bus zone or a clearway.
Got a few.
I think like four or five and at least $100 each.
Tricky signage is often blamed for the confusion.
Maybe they don't know speak English, you know, coming from a different country.
Brisbane drivers handed over $30 million in fines last year. $1 million came from Wickham Street alone. The other hotspots, Margaret and Alice Streets in the CBD. On the Gold Coast, Goodwin Terrace at Burleigh Heads Beach saw almost 15,000 drivers fined. Surfers Paradise Esplanade, the runner-up.
We really want to work cooperatively with councils to make sure more people are getting on trains, more people are getting on buses, and less people feel like they need to drive in and find a park in the city, essentially.
But not every trip can be taken via public transport.
When we poured over every fine issued in Ipswich last year, one street kept jumping out, Woodlinks Way in Collingwood Park, where hundreds of penalties were handed out around school pick-up and drop-off time.
Drivers were also stung on nearby Woodend Road and Woodcrest Way. Councils insist the money raised from fines is used wisely.
It gets put back into the community, ongoing maintenance, the future creation of the footpaths, roads, improvements.
Still a hit to the hip pocket for South East drivers. Jordan Bissell, 7 News.